Hi everyone, welcome to the latest episode of Indie Fix. I'm Adam from eGamer, and today's topic is once again about the indie bubble finally popping. You can refer back to my other video called The Future of Indie to get more information about Jeff Vogel, who will be the focus of this episode once again from Spider Web Software, and I hope you enjoy the show. Cue the theme music. So, how's everyone? If you watched the previous video, I spoke about Jeff Vogel, who was predicting the indie bubble finally popping. And I had a more positive outlook, but in the recent few months, we've seen so many games going onto the Steam store, and there is no curation going on. We see excessive humble bundles, other bundles with indie games, and just a saturation of the market. And normally when a market gets oversaturated, a few developers will not make it in the market, or in this case, many developers. But Jeff Vogel once again writes a really interesting article, but I also want to mention some other articles which sort of influenced me. There was developonline.net, which spoke about, has the indie bubble burst on PC? And they came to the conclusion that if developers are not willing to make well-designed games and put effort into their development cycles, then their games will not make a mark if they want them to. There's also a great discussion of your local South African dev on the Make Games to Save forum about this article by Jeff Vogel. I thought it was quite a good article by Vogel, and there were some really good things I'd like to bring up. So let's start. He brings up the whole thing about the rise of indie gaming of the last few years, and he says that it's been fantastic. There's been a lot of well-funded companies born out of it, like the guys who do Transistor, and because this is right before Transistor came out, and these companies are making top quality games on a reasonable schedule. But he also says that a lot of devs and smaller dev studios are trying to enter the game space, the indie game space, and he isn't so sure about if they're aware that things are changing rapidly. You can't do the exact same tactics of thinking if you release something onto Steam, it'll just be the end of basically all your marketing. And that he feels that a lot of people have forgotten the strategies from back in the day with independent developers of how to actually market your game and to be effective in how to make good quality games instead of just releasing crap, which is the case with the Steam store at the moment. You just don't know where the quality titles are because there's no curation process. And this is the same with a lot of the bundles. You don't know what you get, which is the great game, but it depends on the bundle as well. Some bundles, like the Humble Bundle, you can recognize indie developer's name, like Vlambeer, for instance, and you know that's a sort of name that you can trust because they've produced such good quality games in the past. And basically what Vogel's pointing out that is that there are new obstacles that should be planned for and these problems that you have to take into account. Basically what he is also saying is that the easy money that all developers had access to, well, not really easy money where they made good quality games, but the money isn't as accessible as it used to be. The profits aren't accessible anymore. And if you want to make it in this business, you have to earn it. You can't blame Steam. They were overwhelmed by, over the past few years, by the increase in indie developers trying to get onto the platform, and it's a very hard process to pick and choose who is going to be on your platform. But at the same time, it is necessary, no matter what other people may say negative things about Steam, to have a curation process and to highlight developers that are noteworthy, because this is where you come into this issue. And so what is the evidence that Vogel talks about? Well, he gives a couple of facts that are very interesting, and he links to a couple of articles which you can see in his own article. But he says that Steam released more games in the first 20 weeks of 2014 than in all of 2013. how, and you saw a lot of articles last year with it, like another 100 greenlit games okayed for publishing. So we're seeing an excessive amount of games being released onto Steam, which is the prime platform for indie development at the moment. But what he says is the main issue is that there's a problem with demand, and that almost 40% of games bought on Steam don't get tried. Essentially, they're not launched even once. And this is not a case with free-to-play games, because you're not paying for the game. And he says people mostly don't play these excess games because they don't want them. There's an excessive supply and little demand, basically. And essentially, the flood of games is unmanageable for Steam, and they've opened the floodgates. It's inevitable, and basically this leaves a lot of small developers who might not have the PR marketing skills of medium-sized development studios, or what he calls AAA indies, like Supergiant Games, who released Transistor recently. So there's a whole forces of supply and demand that are in play. And he says what we've seen with devs is this whole thing at play, basically, that indies now do a huge chunk of their business through sales and bundles, and it's a whole process of fighting off other devs, and it's all about making quick money, strip mining your products, and releasing game collections. It makes it difficult for developers. Indie games started as games written with passion for people, says Vogel, and now it's about really turning out very badly designed games. If you just look at early access games, for instance, made by developers, even though those are prototypes, some of them are unplayable. And really what's happening is the market itself, Vogel says, is becoming is not sustainable. It's not going to be as lucrative as it used to be. You have to find the money, essentially. In essence, what it really comes down to is that it's simple mathematics. All gamers together have a huge pool of money for the year to spend on their hobby, and this cash has to get distributed among the developers, and the money can maybe stay constant, go up and down, but the developers and their supply is shooting up. If you have a fixed amount of money, distribution increases, then you're going to have a heavy market to compete within. And this is essentially the market which new developers have to break into. And not everyone is Notch or Jonathan Blow, and they can't, you know, crack the market. There might be people blaming Steam, discoverability issues, and these are issues. And it really comes down to what Vogel thinks is money versus supply and demand. The demand is dictated by people's spending habits and the mass amount of games they're making they want to platforms like Steam. Doesn't mean that everybody's going to get their game to a sales peak that they might want to. But the problem, he says, is that suppose you are mid-tier, what he calls a AAA indie developer, and you have a $500,000, 500k to 2 million budget, you have a problem. You need advertising to get sales, and word of mouth won't necessarily cover everything, but you can't afford big campaigns like AAA devs do, and so your only way to turn a profit is if you get huge free marketing from Steam and from the press, which is why a lot of these mid-tier devs do the expo circuits and or other kinds of press events. They competed for free marketing, and essentially you have a serious problem, especially at things like PAX, where there was over 104 games on show, and those were just indies. And it really is quite depressing to think in those terms and not to think positively anymore about the indie scene and where it's heading. But it is something to consider for indie developers, especially what I discussed last week with the horror stories from Steam Early Access, which is really this bad design practice on the part of devs trying to make a quick buck. We don't need that in the indie scene, but there's always going to be that problem in a market which is very big and thriving. but at the same time, it's going to be a case of supply and demand. Anyway, that's about it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. Subscribe to our channel if you enjoy our content, or just give us a like for the video. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Keep it real. I'll see you next week. Cheers.